Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Now today I'm going to show you how to make this really pretty baby blanket. It's quite a stretchy stitch, but it is lush and thick and it is so warm. I'm going to show you how to make this really pretty fan stitch along the edge as well. Now this is a really simple stitch and yet it comes out so thick with this stitch. It's a fantastic stitch if you've got yarn that's quite thin and you don't know what to do with it. If you use this crochet stitch, then it gives you this beautiful blanket and it's really nice and thick as well. I'm going to show you how to do the stitch and then how to put this edge all around a blanket. You can use this edge for any type of blanket that you have. Now on my ball of yarn, it actually says this is a medium weight. In the UK, it's like a double knitting. It tells you to use a 5mm hook, but I'm actually using a 6.5 because even with a 6.5, look at this, it is just so lush. It's beautiful like that. So any of your baby yarn you like, and I'm using a 6.5 crochet hook, and this is how it's come out. I'm going to do a chain of 20. I'm just doing a little sample for you to see this. Do a loose chain. Now, if you can't do a loose chain, use an even bigger crochet hook. If you do your chain too tight, the bottom of your blanket, it won't be loose like this. It'll be kind of tight and it may turn like this and you'll have a tight edge. So if you do quite a loose chain or use a larger crochet hook to do your chain, it comes out just nice and even with your blanket. I'll move that out of the way. I'm going to do an extra 3 stitches, so I'll have 23. You do the chain for the length that you want for your blanket, 2 and 3. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to treble crochet along this chain. I'm going to go into the 4th space in the chain, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Count to the 4th space in the chain. Wrap my yarn around and go into that stitch. Pull your yarn through, yarn over, through 2 stitches, yarn over and through 2 stitches. So those extra 3 stitches that we put on has become my first. It's become my first stitch in my line. I'm going to do a treble crochet all the way to the end. If you're in the USA or another country, this will be a double crochet for you. In the UK, this is a treble crochet. So yarn over and into the next space in my chain. I'm going to do that all the way to the end. So I have my little sample of 20 stitches. Now what I'm going to show you to do next is really simple. The blanket looks as if it's quite difficult, but it's not. We're going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3 and turn your work. Now what we're going to do is, this is called the post of the stitch. We are going to go behind it like that. Doing that, it's called a front post stitch. The other stitch we're going to do is a back post stitch, where we're going to come through from the back and have this post of a stitch on the back of the hook. We're going to go through the spaces. We're not going through the stitches here. We're going through the spaces to make this rib effect. So the back post one is like this, the front post one through the space be behind the stitch and back through that space on that side. So that's what we're doing. We're going in there and coming back through there. And we're doing this with a treble crochet. So in the USA, that's a double crochet. So yarn over through the space and go behind this stitch. Don't do this one, just leave this one where it is. So in that way and through that way. Put your yarn over, pull through, you've got three stitches, yarn over, through two stitches, yarn over and through two stitches. And it brings your stitch to the front. Now yarn over, we're going to go to the back now. So we're going to come through that space and go back through that space. So you yarn over through the space. So you yarn over through the space and take it your hook to the back. Put your yarn over and pull through. Yarn over through two stitches, yarn over and through your two stitches. And that is taking that stitch through to the back. Yarn over through the space under the post of that stitch, pull through and finish your treble. Yarn over. Now we're going to go through from the back. So it's back, front, all the way along. Finish your treble. Yarn over. Now we're going to do from the front, weave it through, pull your yarn through and finish your stitch. Yarn over from the back. You may have to just pull this part down a little bit so you can see where you're going. Pull through. This becomes really quick. Yarn over through the front. And it does crochet up quite fast as well. Through the back one now. Yarn over, front, finish your crochet treble, yarn over and from the back, finish your treble, and it makes that ribbing like that, and it is double sided as you can see. It's the same on that side as it is on that side, and there's where your stitches have been pulled back, and these are the ones that have been pulled front on that rib. And there's our chain of three. What I'm going to do is just do a normal treble into the top of that chain of three. Push your hook through. And there we go. Oops, I didn't go into the right part there. If you make a mistake, just rip it back. That's the top of my chain there in that one. And through. That's better. So the good thing about crochet is you can just rip it out if you make a mistake. Now, that's your second row. This is so simple. It's the same row all the time. Chain three and turn. And already that stitch is to the front and that stitch is to the back. You can see it like that. Yarn over. Now we start on the front all the time. You'll see it easily if your stitch is to the front or if your stitch looks as if it's like that. And it's at the back of your line of the amount of stitches you've put on. So yarn over, in through the space, pull through, and finish your treble crochet. Yarn over, through to the back now. And you do that all the way to the end. Your last one will be a normal treble crochet in the top of your chain. Chain three and turn, and the same again. A front post treble and then do the back post treble. So now we're on the front post stitch. Yarn over, finish that treble to the back and finish your treble. As you can see, your crochet just builds up and builds up. And that is so easy. That's it. That's it. That is how you do this little blanket. It is just so easy. Treble three, one, chain three, one, two, three, turn it over, and there's my front post stitch, there, right in front of me. Yarn over, through the stitch, pull it through, finish that treble crochet, yarn over, to the back. Once you've got a little bit done, and if you can't quite see, just pull your work and you'll see where the space is. Push to the back and through. Now if you think that you could never have done that, there you go, you can do it now, and it becomes so easy to do. Sometimes your brain just takes over. But what to do, every now and then, just stop and check your row that you've done it correctly. You might have the odd time if somebody's speaking to you. Maybe do two trebles and you need to go back and rip it out so you've not got a mistake away down here and have to rip out half your blanket. The blanket, the height I want it. I've got 64 rows in my blanket. I was using a 6.5 millimeter crochet hook. That's a 6.5. I'm going to change to a 5.5. That's a 5.5 millimeter crochet hook. I want a little bit of a daintier edge like I showed you at the beginning. To work into these spaces, I'm going to chain three. One, two, three. So this set of three chain becomes my first treble crochet. So into the space here, I'm going to put another three treble crochet into that space to make my little shell pattern. One, two, and three. Now the chain I did becomes my fourth one. So I've got one, two, three, four. The next space, I'm just going to do a slip stitch. I'm going to do a slip stitch. Just pull the stitch through and then pull it through that one like that. I'll zoom in just a little bit more. So the next space is going to get four treble crochets. One, two, three, and four. The next space, not that little part there, this actual space, just put your hook through, pull your yarn through and slip that stitch down, and that's given us our second little fan. So into this next stitch, or the next space, sorry, into the next space, we're going to put four treble crochet. We're going to do that all the way down to the bottom. Four treble crochet in one space, slip stitch into the next space, four treble crochet into the next space. So that's four. One, two, three, four. The next space, I'm just going to slip stitch, cross over to the next little space, not that part, leave that part there, into that space there, and I'm going to put four treble crochet into that space. And four. So that'll give me that nice little shell edge all the way down my blanket. I'll work right down to the corner down here, and then I'll show you how to do the corner. We'll work our way along here. I'll show you how to do it on that side, and then work back up using the spaces all the way up this side. Up my little shell stitch all the way down to the corner of this side. Now what I'm going to do is, so I've got one bar spacing here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to go into this corner to do my slip stitch. Slip stitch down into there for that last little shell. Now I'm going to do four into this corner, four trebles into this corner. That's one, two, three, and four. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to slip stitch, just go down, pull it through, pull your yarn through, and through that stitch. And I'm going to put another four into the same space, another four trebles into the same space. That's one, two, three, and four. So there we are, we've done the corner. This is how I've done the corner. I've put two shells into that one corner. Now what we're going to do to work our way along here is, because it's front posts and back posts, I'm going to slip stitch into the first, in between these two posts that are here. I'm going to slip stitch into there. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use the sides of the post. I'm going to go in the side of this long one to do my next little shell pattern. So it's yarn over, and I'm going to do my four treble crochets into there. That's two, three, and four. The clicking noise you can hear in the background is Muttley on the floor. So that gives me my little shell. The next space along, I'm going to slip stitch in. Slip stitch down to make my little shell. I'm going to miss these parts here, and I'm going to this long front post, yarn over, and I'm going to do my four treble crochets into that space to make my next little shell. So I've got one, two, three. One more gives me four. I'm going to go to the next space and do my slip stitch, and that puts that little shell there. I'm going to do that all the way along this part here. So I'm going to miss this section here and go to this one here. If I do all of the sections, it'll be way too wide. So I'm going to slip stitch down into that next space. Oops. The slip stitch. I'm going to skip this gap here and go to this one, this long front post here, and put my four treble crochets in there. Three and four, slip stitch down to the next one, slip stitch down into the next one and move along, and that way it keeps the bottom of your blanket relatively even. If you do it too many times into there, it'll be a way out like that, and we don't want that. We want it to keep that nice running pattern like this down the bottom of the blanket. So I'll do that all the way along. So what I'll be doing is I'll be missing these two. I'll do four trebles into that one, slip stitch into that one, miss these two, then four trebles into that one, slip stitch into that one, then miss the next two. And that way it's keeping that nice run of the front posts on that side, and it's keeping a nice line of the back posts on that side, and that'll be me all the way down, work along, and when I go up the side, I'll put my four in the corner, a slip stitch, then another four trebles, and slip stitch in, and work my way up the hoops like I did on that side to do that. So I'll get that finished and get up to here and come back and show you what the finished blanket looks like. So here is my little baby blanket, all finished. I've got the shell all around the bottom. I've got it down the sides, all down the sides, along the bottom and up the other side. Now this has turned out absolutely beautiful, and it is so soft and chunky as well. And that's from double knitting yarn as well, that it's came out so chunky. It's such a chunky stitch. It's a beautiful stitch, and it makes a beautiful, beautiful baby blanket. You can make anything, make afghans for yourself. This doesn't have to be just for a baby. You can make this blanket for yourself as well, and I think it's turned out absolutely beautiful. So please subscribe to my channel. Just click on that subscribe button down there, and also click on the notification bell. You'll be notified when I put up a new YouTube video, and you'll be one of the first ones to see it if you click on the notification bell and subscribe to the channel. So thank you very much for watching. Until the next time, happy crafting, and I'll see you all again soon. Goodbye.